Alrighty, and welcome back to part 10 of Final Fantasy The Wrong Way. Lastly, we found the Moonflow. We're going to ride the Shoopuff, and we learned about a little bit about Jack's drinking problems. Right, so today we're going to be crossing the Moonflow. I need to actually go and level these guys up a bit, and I'm going to buy them a few items. I keep forgetting I am very, very low on Phoenix Downs. Now, that won't be a problem once Kimari learns how to cast life. And one really interesting thing about this game is when your party members faint, and then you finish a battle, they come back with one life in them. Where in some of the other ones, especially Final Fantasy X-2, the sequel, they're actually knocked out of combat. Which is a very interesting design choice. To have them just come back with one HP instead of actually requiring an item to get back into life. Get Lulu a little bit more mana. She's not going to help her much since she's already got a high base pool. That's everyone. Alright, so this guy over here doesn't look like it, but he's a shopkeeper. Let's see if he's got to have Phoenix Downs. They're pretty common everywhere. So common, I could probably... Yeah, I could afford 99 of them. I'm not going to, because that is pretty wasteful, but buying 20 is not going to really dent me any. Potions only give me 200 HP back, and they're not really worth it at this point, but making sure I have some Echo Screens to get rid of Silence, Soft to get rid of Purification, and a few Eye Drops. We're going to just go to 10. We're going to stop up to 10 of these. Okay, fine, 11, so they're even. It's always nice to have a Echo Screen and Soft, because if you have someone who knows Asuna to get rid of petrification, right, and they're the one that gets petrified, there's not really much you can really do about it. Alright, let's go ride the Shoopuff. There'll be a few cutscenes, and then we'll be getting straight into a boss.
Ride the Shoopuff. All aboard!
All aboard! I love the Hypellos.
Shoopuff launching!
When it's not launching, it's eating. It's a Shoopuff luncheon.
Hey.
Huh?
Take a look.
What? Whoa! A sunken city.
A machina city, 1,000 years old. They built the city on top of bridges across a river.
But the weight of the city caused the bridges to collapse, and it all sank to the bottom.
Right, it's a good lesson.
A lesson?
Yeah. Why build a city over a river, yeah?
Well, it would be convenient with all that water there.
Nope, that's not why. They just wanted to prove they could defy the laws of nature.
I'm not so sure about that.
Yevon has taught us. When humans have power, they seek to use it. If you don't stop them, they go too far, yeah?
Yeah, but don't you use machina too? Like the stadium and stuff, right?
Yevon, it decides which machina we may use and which we may not.
So what kind of machina may we not use, then?
Remember Operation Meehan? That kind.
Or war will rage again.
War?
More than 1,000 years ago, mankind waged war using machina to kill.
They kept building more and more powerful machina.
They made weapons so powerful, it was thought they could destroy the entire world.
The people feared that Spira would be destroyed.
But the war did not stop.
What happened then?
Sin came, and it destroyed the cities and their machina.
The war ended, and our reward was sin.
So, sin's our punishment for letting things get out of hand, eh?
Man, that's rough.
Yeah, it is.
But it's not like the Machina are bad.
Only as bad as their users.
It's because of people like the Albed screwing everything up.
What could that be?
Sit down.
Sorry! Ah!
The Albed! Luna, we'll save you!
It should be a pretty straightforward fight. Like all Machina, they are weak to lightning. And thanks Tidus is our crappy black mage, we have the option to really knock that down. There's not much I can really do. It's gonna be immune to power break, but I'm gonna hit it anyways just because I've never actually tried to power break it. Is it? Holy crap, it is not immune to power break. I've never made Waka or Tidus learn power break this early in the game. I stand corrected. You learn something new every day. As for the usual, I'm going to cheer up. Normally this fight would be a little bit easier because I would have Tidus haste himself, but since he does not know it, neither does Waka, sadly we're gonna have to just do it with some brute force. Oh no, Waka's got so little mana that he can only cast one ability. Oh, whoopsie-daisies. Oh, well, this fight's gonna be over pretty quickly. They're on tier number, what, 3 or 4? I'm gonna do one more for safekeeping, because Tidus isn't really gonna do much. So this is the part where I would constantly fail when I was trying a no-sphere grid on accident. So he would go up to ready depth charges, which means you get a free turn to hit him. And I just couldn't do enough damage to bring him back down. You just have to hit him multiple times and he comes back down. Probably just this hit. Especially if it was a crit, he'd just sink back. I think the threshold is like 500 damage. I'm not quite so sure. The Aqua Shooter comes out. It's gonna do decent damage, but Power Break and 4x2 is just gonna make it not worth anything anymore. Lightning's gonna do 190 damage and 170, close enough. So we're gonna slot. Just because I can. It's after 5. Oops. This is bad. This is really bad. I am not good at the reels. I only do one reel and that's attack reels. Oh well. Still did damage. So if Tidus does 162 damage on my hand, I wonder if he hits more with just a basic attack. Let's find out. My suspicion is it'll be, yeah, especially with that 4x cheer. He's not gonna have any hard time. Once he gets second tier magic, he should be on par with around 300, 400 damage, which is Lulu's current damage. Hey, get down here. This fight should go good. Yeah, we got one more turn. So there's no way we're gonna lose a party member here. And we are done. Give it a good crit, Waka. Oh, we still got the overkill. Wow. It's got really low overkill value. I was always curious, if it blew up that violently, how did they get Yuna out? As Especially since she does not know how to swim yet.
Are you hurt?
No, I'm fine.
Gah, those outbed.
Ish everybody okay?
I'm sorry. We're all okay now.
Yuna.
Shoopa, full speed ahead.
I love the high powers. They're just so fun.
Damn
to
the outbed. What do they want from us? Could it have something to do with Luca? What are they after Yuna for? Wait, they're mad they lost the tournament. Oh, wait, they're mad about Operation Meehan.
I wonder, didn't Kamari's clansmen say something about summoners disappearing?
Ah, so the outbed are behind that. Those sandblasted grease monkeys.
Hey, Waka. It's no use complaining about the Albed now, right? We'll protect Yuna from anyone, anywhere. It's that easy. That's all I need to know.
Well, I guess so.
You're right.
I have no idea if the microphone picked it up. Since I'm on cardioid, I'm away from my window, but someone just drove by, probably like a Ford compact car, and it sounded like they didn't have a muffler on it. Like it probably rusted and fallen off. That was incredibly loud through walls and windows. I hope that doesn't show up though. That'd be annoying to hear. Alright, so. Fun thing to touch about on the war that they mentioned. So, they said there's a war between giant Machina cities. In reality, it wasn't a war between giant Machina cities, plural. It was, well, it is still technically plural, but it was only two cities. Zanarkand and a city we will find later on called Bavel. Now, Bavel was a militaristic city, where Zanarkand was less so. It was more religious, magic-based, and focused on being nice to their people.
You're not dead?
Thought I was done for back there.
Riku! You're Riku! Hey! You're okay! How you been?
Terrible.
Yeah, you don't look so good. What happened?
You beat me up, remember?
Huh? Oh, that Machina? That was you?
Mm-hmm. Oh, that really hurt, you know. You big meanie.
Wait, but you attacked us!
Nuh-uh. It's not exactly what you think.
Yo! Friend of yours.
And you could say that.
Pleased to meet ya. I'm Riku.
Yuna? Lulu? I told you about her, remember? She was the one who helped me before I was washed up on Besaid. She's an Albed.
Wow, so you like all your life. What luck meeting here, huh? Praise be to Yevon. So, Riku, you look a little beat up. You okay?
Waka.
Huh? What?
There's something we need to discuss.
Oh, go ahead.
Girls only. Boys, please wait over there.
Right. Sorry, Waka.
Huh? What? Ah.
Sir Orin, I would like Riku to be my guardian.
Show me your face.
Huh?
Look at me.
Oh, okay.
Open your eyes. As I thought.
No good?
Are you certain?
100%. So, anyway, can I?
If Yuna wishes it.
Yes, I do.
Riku's a good girl. She helped me a bunch.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm for it. The more the merrier.
Righto. Then I'll just have to be the merriest.
It was strange. Even though Waka had always hated the Albed.
Riku, at your service.
He never realized Riku was one of them.
It's kind of slightly jarring how Waka says praise be to Yevon, because he doesn't say that very often. It's like, he's thanking his god, and it's purposely put there in front of someone that you as a player know is an Albed, but just to make this kind of, like, setup that you know
oh,
at some point
chest.
This is all gonna come crashing down and there's gonna be a conflict.
I wonder what's inside.
I feel like it was a little bit over the top to make him go out of his way, because he doesn't normally act like that. Yay, bomb cores!
Yahoo! You should know.
I call it
I'm
shenanigans.
Scary when I get mad.
Should
I'm
do
gonna
way
use that item I just got
damage.
On you.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna keep the bomb core. Gonna mix. I have a lot of power too. Get out of here.
What did you just do?
That was great!
I can combine items and use them like this. It's not that tough, really.
So now we have our thief in the party, which, if memory serves me correct, and I'm pretty sure it is, she's our blue maid. So I can kind of shove her wherever I feel like she needs to go. And I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with her. I think I might keep her as a thief, but I don't know if that'd be really wise. Having her be a thief might not be the best thing. Orin's about 9 levels before getting steel and fuse. I'm gonna just keep her down her path. I'm gonna then actually. Do I wanna keep her down the path or do I wanna shove her down Tidus's path? Questions, questions, decisions, decisions. I will figure it out along the way. We'll wing her. Low on ability spheres, as per usual. Dent that one. I'm gonna kill it. Hopefully. So close. Can Mari kill it? There's no way. He's not gotten any strength. Yeah. know she can't. Maybe? Yeah, no, that's not gonna kill it. It's gonna be around like 505. Switch Waka back in since he's not done anything. Hit the belly in the face of the ball. We're a lot more than needed to be. Bring Riku in.
I'll do my best.
Might as well steal from it. Get the Arctic and Antarctic wind. And
miss me?
Cast fire on it. Okay.
Yeah!
That was so. Before Riku showed up, it was a lot easier to get everyone in because there's only six, and one full rotation switch would get me it all in. Now I have to wait for an additional one.
Not again!
Oh, this is really good.
Think of it as training.
So, if I'm lucky, I can get a poison fang from these things as a rare steal. Now, how easy that's going to be, I have no idea. I stole from this one, so it's going to be a lot harder to steal from. I'm not this guy. I'm going to extract ability on it. Since
Let
I can't
come.
One-shot it, there's really no reason to try to switch orders and rely on a crit like that. So I'm just going to also steal from this flyer. Darn. And replace it. Perfect time to bring Kamari in and fix that. And knock it out of the sky. I had a feeling that was gonna happen. She's incredibly fragile. At a 360 health right now.
I thought I was gonna die.
Yeah, you might actually.
So be it.
Okay. Lulu hasn't had a turn, and that's fine. And a steal. Dragon scale. Nice. A really nice water item. Tidus also hasn't had a turn. Those things are very resistant to magic, so I'm just not going to use that. And we're going to bring one back into the forest. If Riku's grid is anything like it was before, should have a lot of HP very quickly. So she'll go from having 360 to probably around 1,000 pretty quickly. Darn, if that was a 400, that'd have been really nice. That's unfortunate. Three more magic for Kamari is pretty big. It's not super duper large, since he is. It'll just make him cast a little bit better when it comes to white mage stuff. Tidus still has a while to go before he gets his second tier magic. I should already honestly be there by now if I wasn't confidangling everyone's fear grid like this. Especially since I'm running from a lot of fights, I'm not getting the levels really needed to get these guys going. And that's okay. Alright, to Guada Salam, or awkward cutscenes galore. We've got one, two, three, maybe four or five cutscenes coming up.
We have been expecting you, Lady Yuna. Welcome to Guado Salam. This way, m'lady. This way.
Me?
Whoa! Oh, I beg your pardon. I am called Trommel Guado. I am in the direct service of our leader, the great Seymour Guardo. Lord Seymour has very important business with Lady Yuna.
Business with me? Whatever could it be, I wonder?
Please, come inside the manor. All will be explained. Of course, your friends are also welcome.
Twist our arms, why don't you? Ah, I almost forgot.
So I'm gonna skip this, but the gist of it is, just like the ability to teach your Aeons different spells and other things, we can do the same for weapons with open slots. So, and it's all based on items that, like, to make Fire Strike, you require four bomb cores. There is a ton of fantastic things you can do with customization for weapons. We're just gonna grab a buckler, fireproof, darkproof, a lot of the status removes HP plus 20%, which is nice and all, but we're gonna be hitting cap anyway, so it's really worthless. Auto Phoenix, which is fantastic because it'll automatically not use a turn to revive someone. It's pretty important for some of the side and optional quests. Auto Med is okay, I guess, but since this is the international version, you'd probably rather want to have Ribbon to get to not take the status effects in the first place. Alrighty, let's start this. While we wait, we have to, I think, go talk to Lulu. Yeah.
These are the past leaders of the Guado.
They all look the same.
Maester Seymour doesn't look like them, though.
Don't you know?
That's racist.
The last leader, Maester Jiskel, wed a human woman. She was Seymour's mother.
Huh. All right, now if I try to leave... Yep. When in doubt, try to leave.
This way, please. I will go inform Lord Seymour. Please wait here.
Alright, so we need to go talk to, I think, Warren?
Stay on your guard.
Why? This guy is just a priest, right?
Those with power use that power. Maesters have power.
Wait. You sure you don't have something against Yevon?
I lived a long time in Zanarkand.
Ah.
And I think we have to go talk to Lulu as well.
I get the feeling he called...
There we go.
There's no temple here in Guadasalam, see? Summoners usually just pass through on their way elsewhere. What?
I didn't even ask a question and you're explaining things.
You'd rather I say nothing, then?
No. Maybe you finally believe I don't know anything about Spira. And maybe that means you believe me about Zanarkand, too?
Well... There are many things I do not know. Your Zanarkand is one of those things. I suppose I can't say what I think, either way. Still, be careful. You shouldn't tell other people.
Yeah, I know.
Might have to go have a dialogue.
What could it...
Kimari na...
Shh!
I like Kimari.
Kimari, speak no more.
There we go. I think I just have to talk to everyone once.
Truly, it is good to have guests again. Since Lord Giskell passed away, these halls have been too quiet.
The death of Lord Giskell was a great loss for all of Spira.
Was this Maester Giskell really such a great guy?
He brought the teachings of Yevon to the Guado. He was truly a great man.
Truly a loss for us all. But now a new leader, Lord Seymour, has come before us. Lord Seymour is the child of a Guado and a human. He will be the tie that binds our two races together. But that is not all, I think. Lord Seymour, he will surely become the shining star that lights the way for all the peoples of Spira.
That is enough, Trommel. Must I always endure such praise? Welcome!
You wanted to see me?
Please, make yourselves at home. There's no rush.
Please keep this short. Yuna must rush.
Pardon me. It has been a long time since I had guests. Lady Yuna, this way. This sphere is a reconstruction created from the thoughts of the dead that wander the far.
Zanarkand?
Correct. Zanarkand, as it looked 1,000 years ago. The great and wondrous Machina city, Zanarkand. She once lived in this metropolis.
She who? Lady Unaleska!
She was the first person to defeat sin and save the world from its ravages. And you have inherited her name.
It was my father who named me.
Lord Braska was entrusting you with a great task. He wanted you to face sin as Lady Unaleska did. However, Lady Unaleska did not save the world alone. To defeat the undefeatable sin, it took an unbreakable bond of love, of the kind that binds two hearts for eternity.
Wow, your face is beet red.
You okay?
He asked me to marry him.
You serious? Hey!
You know what Yuna must do.
Of course. Lady Yuna. No, all summoners are charged with bringing peace to Spira. But this means more than just defeating sin. She must ease the suffering of all Spira. She must be a leader for the people. I proposed to Lady Yuna as a maester of Yevon.
Spira is no playhouse. A moment's diversion may amuse an audience, but it changes nothing.
Even so, the actors must play their parts. There's no need to answer right away. Please, think it over.
We will do so then. We leave.
Lady Yuna, I await your favorable reply. Why are you still here, sir? I beg your pardon. We Guado are keen to the scent of the Far Plane.
So, completely against what just happened, while in that cinematic, which is a very, very pretty cinematic, one of my favorites in this game, you hear as they're just zooming through Zanarkand, just as they get put down on the ground level, the Machina billboard talking about the Machina weapons, which is a very brief split second talking about the war that they were fighting with Bavel. Now, it's just very much like our local news is in this world, how it's just constantly yammering and not a lot of people pay attention to it.
Yuna, the High Summoner's daughter, Seymour, the leader of the Guado, married in the name of Yevon, overcoming the barriers of race. It would give Spira something cheery to talk about for a change.
Sounds just like a passing daydream, like Auron says.
Come on, let's just get on with the pilgrimage. I mean, marriage?
Jealous?
What? No way. We gotta defeat sin. Romance can wait.
You sure picked a fine time to lay this one on us.
Maybe it is a fine time.
You serious?
If my getting married would help Spira, if it would make people happy, if I could do that for people, maybe I should do what I can. I never imagined doing anything like this. But I won't answer till I know what's right.
Seriously?
You could always just quit your pilgrimage and get married.
I will. Go on. I'm sure that Lord Seymour will understand.
I guess so.
I am a summoner. I must fight and defeat sin.
Like Braska before you.
I had to stop myself from shouting.
What's there to think about?
I'm going to the Far Plane. I'm going to see my father and think on this.
Go on. We'll be right behind you.
I wondered why none of the others ever asked Yuna. Do you love Seymour? Do you even like him?
So we're gonna make our way over to the Far Plane. There's a very dubious hidden item right there. You won't get to get again for very a long while if you miss it now.
Question about this Far Plane. When somebody dies, a summoner sends them to the Far Plane, right? So their souls, or whatever they are, they go to the Far Plane, right? But that's the Far Plane we're going to, right? And Yuna's old man's there too? Do dead people live there or something?
You thinking those funny thoughts again, yeah? You'll see once we get there.
Aren't you coming?
I do not belong there.
You're scared.
Searching the past to find the future. This is all that is there. I need it not. You'd better be going.
You're not really going to see the dead. More like your memories of them. People think of their relatives, and the Pyreflies react to them. They take on the form of the dead person. An illusion, nothing else. Well, have fun.
What? You're not going either, Riku?
I keep my memories inside.
Huh?
Memories are nice, but that's all they are.
So let's go head into this far plane thing. And be greeted by more cutscenes.
What the? The far plane was cool, but I couldn't stop thinking about Yuna. Her parents, they looked so happy together. But it got me worried that maybe seeing them would make Yuna really consider Seymour's proposal.
Yo, Chapu! Meant to come see you earlier, yeah? Sorry. I know you won't hold it against me. I gave up the game. I'm a guardian from here on, you know? This guy looks a lot like you. Showed up. Traveling with him, I thought maybe you were still alive somewhere, yeah? But then again, here you are on the far plane. Guess your place is here. So, how you been? Oh, that guy I just told you about? I gave him your sword. He likes it.
Huh? Whoa.
He is dead, and I am still alive. Coming here really makes that clear. I should focus more on what I have to do now.
What?
I'm not even sure what I'm saying.
Don't you mean that you should leave Chapu behind? I'm sure he was a great guy, but there'll be others.
That's a possibility.
How about Waka?
What, me? With Waka?
Yeah, you two get along great.
Getting along isn't enough. Not even close.
Oh, sorry. My mistake.
You'd do well to remember that. Knowing a bit about women might come in handy someday.
Yeah, I'll remember.
I won't be forgetting either. Goodbye, Chapu. You always said I looked grumpy. But those were the happiest days of my life.
So
So, Yuna?
I've decided.
Oh, really? That's good.
I remember when I was only 7 years old in Bavel that day. My father had defeated Sin, and the whole town was out in the streets. Everyone was laughing. They all seemed so happy. If I defeated Sin, that would make everyone happy, wouldn't it? I must do what everyone wants, not just what I want.
Let's go back. You gotta tell Seymour.
Before that, call Sir Jet. Give it a try.
Huh?
Don't worry. He won't come.
Trying not to think about my old man made me think about him, of course.
See, told you.
He isn't here because he's not dead. He's Sin.
That means he's alive, you know.
What if my old man really is Sin? What would I say to Yuna? Heck, to everybody in Spira. Wait, why should I have to apologize for him anyway? I'd rather never see him again.
What makes you hate him so?
Everything he does just makes me mad. It was his fault that me and my mother... Mom? It's her.
She's very pretty.
I mean, you kind of have to marry a Blitzball legend.
Wait. No one ever performed the sending for her.
She must have accepted death while she was still alive.
Whoa there. That's my mother you're talking about.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. I think I just figured something out.
What?
Why I hate my old man.
See? So I told him what I thought of him right there.
What? Really?
Of course.
I suppose, but... Mommy! Just a sec, dear.
Whenever my old man was around, my mother wouldn't even look at me. Maybe that's when I started to resent him, even hate him. When he left us, Mom just lost her energy.
Is she all right?
Why should you care?
If she dies, I wouldn't know what to do.
Don't say Mom is gonna die.
I apologize.
The old lady next door told me, when a lovebird dies, the one left behind, it just gives up living so it can join its mate. It was just like that. I hated my old man even more. But really, my old man...
Mommy! Just a sec, dear.
Go to him. He'll cry if you don't.
Oh, man. I must sound so stupid.
I don't think so.
How embarrassing.
Well, need some more time.
No. I'm ready.
Did I miss something?
Thanks for waiting. I'll go give my answer to Maester Seymour.
Lord Jiskel!
Oh, Lord Jiskel!
He does not belong here.
Why?
Yuna, send him.
Lord Jiskel.
He is Lord Jiskel no more. Send him now.
uh, 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 uh,
We leave now.
What was that just now? That really Lord Disco?
I don't understand how a man like Lord Jiskel can die and not be sent.
I would think that he was sent once, but he stayed on Spira. Something, a powerful emotion, could have bound him to this world. Such things happen.
That's against the rules, isn't it?
It means he died an unclean death.
So that's a really interesting thing. There's been a lot of hints dropped. Just how Seymour talked to Orin, how Orin reacted when going to the Far Plane and when on the way out of Far Plane should be leaving some pretty big hints down. And it's pretty obvious the second time you play it. One of these things has the save sphere. Running a little bit over the where I'd like to be on the 45 minutes. Oh, it's all the way back at the start. Wonder if I can get out without triggering the next cutscene. There's no way. Oh, I got lucky. Yes, this one has the save sphere in it. Alright, we're gonna save it there and call it for this episode. That was a lot of cutscenes and a boss battle, but thank you so much for watching. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you want to see more. And until next time, I hope you all have a fantastic day, and I will see you in the next one.